What up? My name is Adrian from Roboto TV, and today we will be breaking down Season 7, Episode 1 of Game of Thrones, and in particular, the Valonqar theory, and what Jaime and Cersei's positions on the map of West... Joking. How are you guys? Did you have a good weekend? Did your team have a friendly? And did they do well in it? Or did they get crushed 5-1 by young boys? Like Benfica did. And no, I'm not saying that Benfica got crushed by young little boys. That's the name of the team, of course. This video will mostly be transfers, but I'll throw some other shit in there as well. So don't you worry. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you have not yet, because I've been thinking of you lately. We've got transfers of Aguero, Lucas Leiva, Morata, AC Milan, Everton, AC Milan, Everton, and much, much more. But let's start with one of the biggest transferees of this summer having his debut, Lukaku. Did you watch it? And what did you think of what you saw? I only was able to catch the second half of the match as I had some plans on Saturday night, but Lukaku to me looked like a player who had just gotten back from vacation, was playing for the first time ever with his new team, new teammates, for about 45 minutes in the first preseason game of the tour. That's what he looked like to me. Was he great? No. Was he awful? No. His first touch was okay, his passing was spotty at times, he was extremely strong on the ball, as we expected, and his finishing was shaky AF. But I mean, I don't really understand the United fans and fans of other clubs, of course, that are saying that he was trash in this match. I mean, I commend Martial, he played pretty damn well, though he was super greedy at times. There was moments when he could have laid the ball off to either one of the men on his right or left, and it would have been a better opportunity for them. Sometimes that man was Lukaku, but instead Martial was shooting again and again and again. However, I think United fans will be happy to see that, as Martial looks like he is up for it this season and he's ready to fight for his place. And maybe those transfer rumors about him will just float away. But enough of Lukaku, let's look at another striker that came to the Premier League in Alexandre Lacazette. His team, Arsenal, are cleaning up, as you'd expect, against their A-League opposition. And in Lacazette's first match for Arsenal, he became Alexandre Lacazette. Shout out to Ashley Rodriguez for that one, as he finished a tidy tap-in to score his first ever Arsenal goal. Giroud, on the other hand, has been scoring as well, as he will not go quietly into that night, as it is dark and full of terrors. No more Game of Thrones, I'm sorry. Honestly, I think that Arsenal fans would be happy to have Giroud as a backup to Lacazette, but I'm not an Arsenal fan. So, Arsenal fans, what do you think? Do you want Giroud? Do you want him out? There hasn't been a ton of marquee friendlies yet, but they are starting up this week. We'll have better clashes in the ICC, or the International Champions Cup if you're not from North America, and I will do my best to follow them and report to you guys what's going on in the preseason. But for now... of course, after I shot this episode, Neymar has erupted all over the headlines, as apparently he wants out of Barcelona. The two teams who have been linked with him the most are Manchester United and PSG, as PSG are apparently willing to pay his 222 million buyout clause. I don't know, I feel like he is linked to a shocking Barcelona exit every season now, but it would be pretty cool to see him in the Premier League with somebody, no? Also, his reasons for leaving are probably around the same as what Ronaldo does every few seasons. I'm unhappy. Oh, here's a new contract. You know, that kind of thing. Oh my god, guys, Everton signed another one, though this one isn't that exciting. They got Cuco Martina on a free transfer from Southampton. I know what you're saying.
Who?
He's not great. He's been exposed time and time again as a fullback that has a tough time defending, like this. Moonwalking on him. Some Southampton fans have said that he's decent going forward, but I don't see him being anything more than just a squad player at Everton. Alvaro Morata, who some sources say is close to joining AC Milan. Wow. Never heard of AC Milan signing a player before. In fact, did you know that AC Milan's owners have spent a record amount in their first year of ownership? But regarding Morata, if you chose me as a source, I would say that it's bullshit. For now, at least, given that Morata has previously said that he is loyal to Juventus and he doesn't see himself returning to the Serie A. Players change their minds all the time, and players talk and say bullshit all the time. But the £61 million transfer with £166,000 per week for Morata just doesn't smell right to me. I'm not saying it won't happen, but it just doesn't seem likely. But if these rumors are true, it could explain why Chelsea has turned their attention from Alvaro Morata to Manchester City striker Sergio Aguero, who hasn't had the easiest of relationships with Pep Guardiola so far. I get some frenemy bad vibes between these two, from these two, between them, is what I meant to say. If Chelsea does turn to Aguero and they do end up signing him, how do you guys think he would do in their attack? My initial thought is, of course, that they will have zero physical presence in their attack and won't score many goals from crosses unless guys like Bakayoko make late runs into the box for cutback crosses, etc. But Aguero's movement and ability with the ball and without it are undisputed. He's been one of the best strikers in the Premier League in the last 4 or 5 years. And I honestly think that he has a bit of a chip on his shoulder going into this season. After last season, there was a lot of criticism on Aguero, even from Pep Guardiola. And I'm looking back at the match against AS Monaco, the second leg in the Champions League, when he said, if Aguero had finished some of those chances, he didn't say Aguero, but he said our strikers had finished those chances, we would have been in a better position or something like that. I mean, don't quote me on it. I don't have this shit memorized. So ultimately, my verdict on this transfer happening, Aguero to Chelsea, is a big old doubt it, but stranger things have happened. Still on City, Sky is reporting that Joe Hart has passed his medical to complete a loan move to West Ham and taken straight off the whack shelf, or whack if true shelf. Pep Guardiola is looking to another Pep in Pepe Reina from Napoli as a replacement for Joe Hart as the backup goalkeeper, which they need given that Willy Caballero signed for Chelsea in this offseason. But I mean, City fans, do you really want Pepe Reina as your backup goalkeeper? Is he the guy that's going to keep Ederson honest and maybe give him some guidance along the way? I mean, maybe guidance, yes, but competition? I'm not so sure. City have offered $3 million for him, but Napoli are holding out for that big boy, $5 million. Will they ever come to an agreement? Back to Chelsea again quickly, as Alexandro seemed like a sure thing to sign on from Juventus, just as Danilo seemed like a sure thing to sign on from Real Madrid to Juventus, as numerous agencies reported that they were both pretty much done deals. However, it's looking like the old switch em up, as Real Madrid and Chelsea are very close to finalizing a deal to send Danilo to London. Oh, what a weird market, man. It seems like every single player has been linked with every single team in the world. I guess it's not so much the market as it is the media blowing every smidgen of a story out of control. But yeah, get me anyways, right? I honestly am split on this deal, as I don't know that Danilo has the quality to play in the Premier League. However, all the transfer prices that are being thrown out there for Danilo are like under 20 million. So at that price, take your chances on it, Chelsea. You have the money. He could be a good backup to Moses and give him some competition. I'm sure he's better defensively than Moses, but going forward, how's this crossing and his interplay with other players? I don't know if he can match Moses. All right, here are some quick stories for you guys. It's going down. Diego Costa and Antonio Conte are gonna fight in a bare knuckle brawl because Diego Costa disrespected Chelsea, not the girl in class, the football club, by wearing an Atletico Madrid jersey during an Instagram live stream. What? But in all seriousness, this seems like a sure thing now. No? Costa to Atletico Madrid? It's gotta be real. It would look pretty stupid on Costa, though not so surprising, if he did this kind of thing when the deal wasn't close to being finalized. And Mr. Cesc Fabregas didn't do himself any favors by commenting a little ja-ja-ja laugh crying emoji on said live stream. Mr. Conte is not gonna like that, is he? So it's looking like Costa is Mr. Audi 5000, and it's being reported that he could be making a move to Besiktas for 6 months before he signs on with Atletico Madrid, because everybody knows they can't sign anybody. And I'm pretty excited, if he does go, to see him playing alongside Antoine Griezmann. That's a pretty crazy attack. Mateo Kovacic, where's he going? Well, he had the highest dribble success ratio of any player in La Liga last season, despite only attempting around 50 dribbles. Higher than Neymar, higher than Messi, higher than Ronaldo. That's, well, he's not really a dribbler anymore. Higher than them all. So where is he going? Well, it's looking like he might make a return back to the Serie A, or at least Those are the clubs that are interested in him. Napoli, AC Milan, a return to Inter Milan perhaps. Every time I've seen him play, and I've seen him play in training as well, shout out Montreal Impact for hosting Real Madrid last year, he's looked very good. Good on the ball, decent vision, good passing. And I think right now, especially at this very vital point of his career, he just needs minutes. So whatever he ends up doing, whether it's staying or going, if they can guarantee him minutes, that's a good move for him. And if I was him, that's what I would be looking for. Mind you, I'm not a professional football player, never have been, so why listen to me? But you know it's going to be very difficult to move past Toni Kroos and Luka Modric in the Real Madrid starting 11. So go somewhere on loan, dude. It's no secret that Juve are looking to sign a brand new CDM, as the main man, Massimiliano Allegri, has asked them to do just that. And apparently the frontrunners are Matic, Nzonzi, and William Carvalho. A slightly underwhelming list if you ask me, but I guess that just goes to show how in demand these kind of players are right now. And finally, last one guys, it's the end of an era in Liverpool. Which era? The Lucas Leiva era, as he has finalized a deal for £5 million to go from Merseyside to Lazio. Damn, I feel like he's been there forever, the last 10 years. He said his goodbyes at Melwood 48 hours ago, and his team took off to, what is it, Hong Kong that Liverpool's playing in right now? I don't know. And he took off to Rome. I think net-net, he will be a good signing for Lazio, as his experience will be huge for some of the younger players. And the pace of the Serie A, which is a little bit slower and less robust than the Premier League, will suit him a little bit better. All right, this episode is over, man. That's it. Thank you so much for tuning in once again, and best of luck to you and your team, as I'm sure they're playing someone soon, today, tomorrow, this week, for sure. And hey, hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Adrian, out.